The RBI governor on Friday morning came out with a slew of measures to help lenders as well as their borrowers. While the announcement came out, there was a lot of excitement about how exactly borrowers can benefit with the 3-month moratorium on their term loan repayments. However, later in the day, the Reserve Bank of India put out a detailed circular about how these things will be calculated and how, which borrowers can actually benefit from it. That was a little more sobering. So let's try and understand how these guidelines will be implemented. First and foremost, let's try and understand what exactly is on offer. According to what the Reserve Bank of India's latest guidelines say, every lender in India, which includes banks, NBFCs, All India Finance Institutions, and all other forms of lenders, microfinance institutions included, can actually defer repayments by 3 months on term loans. What are term loans? Well, essentially, term loans will include all retail as well as corporate loans, any kind of bullet repayments, EMIs, or any credit card dues that might be due in the coming few days. These repayments will be deferred between March 1st and May 31st. So for those 3 months, borrowers will not be required to pay these repayments. And that, according to the RBI, is allowed without attracting any kind of asset quality issues. We'll get to the asset quality issues later, but let's try and understand firstly, who is eligible to access these facilities. Now, the RBI in its detailed circular says that each bank has to come out with each bank as well as each lender has to come out with a board-approved policy on how exactly they're going to implement these guidelines. In that, they've said that the banks will get to then choose, depending on this board-approved policy, which eligible lenders qualify for these guidelines. So it is leaving actually everything to the banks to decide which borrowers will qualify for these benefits. Essentially, what bankers are saying is that if a borrower is capable of repaying their dues as of now, then they should continue doing so and not avail of these facilities. These facilities are specifically for people whose incomes have been affected by the coronavirus, as well as the later impact because of the national lockdown that is happening in India. So those people whose incomes are affected, this scheme is mainly for them because they will not be able to repay their loans. Apart from this, the RBI has also said that this will be working capital limits can also be extended for their corporate borrowers of banks as well as NBFCs for another period of 3 months, which is between March 1st and May 31st. As is with the term loans, this again, each of these measures will not attract any kind of asset quality issues. So essentially, even within 90 days, if borrowers are not paying back those loans, then for these 90 days, they will not be classified as non-performing assets. The interest on whatever dues are pending will continue to accrue for this three-month period. And at the end of this 90-day period, the borrowers will have to pay back whatever interest has been accrued during this period. Apart from this, the credit information bureaus will also not downgrade the credit scores and ratings of each borrowers who are using these facilities. So all in all, it is beneficial for borrowers who are going to access these facilities, but it is up to the banks to decide who exactly will qualify and whether this borrower should receive this facility, this deferment of 3 months or not.